beginning are always tough, but you have to keep moving on.
I think it's your limitless dreaming that brings about a revolution. Pioneers have to chalk out their own paths.
Every journey has its ups and downs. The climb to the top is always full of challenges.
Harnessing wind energy to generate power for the last 20 years now, Suzlon is a story of belief, persistence, and transformation. Promising the world a greener tomorrow, it is one of the world's leading wind turbine generators with a global presence.
It's been a good 20 years. I remember whenever we spoke to the different people about our idea of harnessing wind energy, they suggested us to dream within limits. Clearly, we didn't take their suggestions, and today we have transformed the way people look at environment, energy, and power. When I look back the 1990, when we are in the textile business, it was very difficult for the textile business to compete in a continuous basis because cost of energy in our country was very, very expensive. If I can find out the solution and if I can hedge my power cost for the next 25 years, then and then in the textile business, we will remain the competitive and we can able to grow.
That time, our chairman, Mr. Tulsi, has decided to put a 2 windmill for Suzlon Fibers Limited. वहाँ से तुलसी भाई एंड गिरीश भाई ने सोचा कि ये डाइवर्सिफिकेशन के लिए बिजनेस अच्छा है।
When we started this Suzlon Energy Limited in 1995 and when we received the first order from IPCL, that was a very prestigious order for the organization. And at the same time, no one at a senior level was having a very specific experience towards the wind industry.
There were very hard and difficult times. There was lack of communication. No mobile phones, no internet, and very less information on the turbine.
It was completely new concept. People, the customers were not aware of how a wind turbine can generate a power, how the power can be used for sale to electricity board, from where they can get the monthly revenue. It took initially a lot of efforts for us actually.
In the beginning of 1995, when we are going to the customers, particularly if I say Rahul Bajaji, and I have convinced him and try to explain him about the investment in the renewable energy. They said, Tante, it's very difficult to digest this and such a huge investment. Are you willing to give your personal guarantees? And finally, he was convinced and he has invested. I think that was the journey of the initial year.
My best wishes, all the best. And we hope that our Bajaj Suzlon Association continues for many decades.
That time, we worked out a very innovative idea, which is called as a wind park concept.
Until then, mostly wind turbines were installed one here, one there, like that. So we said, okay, we will not do it like this. We will take a large area, do the entire engineering design for that large scale of several hundred megawatts that you can build, and with a design where it can work for a 20-year period in terms of the entire life of the project. It just change the whole perception of all the stakeholders, whether it's the bankers, customers, vendors, suppliers, everybody. Largely because now what was happening is that if you are buying just one turbine or if you are buying say 50 turbines, you would still get the service excellence and the product excellence of a large park.
I remember at one of the site in Satara, a turbine supply to Tata Group, it had some problem actually. And we got a call from the MD of that company that I want turbine to be restored in the next 72 hours. It was very difficult task, but company took that as a challenge. Let's make it happen actually. Within 48 hours, the turbine was restored actually. And that gave so much delight to the entire team of Tata. And after that, initially from 10 megawatt order, they also went up to 80 megawatt order with us actually.
And then we executed the various orders in Gujarat. Then we started business in Maharashtra, so we shifted to Daman. Then the business started in Tamil Nadu. So the another factory was started in Pondicherry. Like that, the journey began.
Suzlon's journey has been quite fulfilling, with one step leading to another. This journey, though, hasn't been devoid of obstacles.
I remember very well in the month of June 1998, very early morning, we got a message that a very severe cyclone, which was expected to hit the Gujarat coast, has hit very severely actually, and it has damaged almost every turbine in that area actually.
Because of this cyclone, 24 of this turbine was just ravished. Nothing sustained. The towers were twisted, thrown to the ground. the energy towers which were tubular were uprooted from the foundation and were lying on the ground. So it was really a huge incident.
I heard many people talking in the industry, Suzlon is now vanished. But then we took that incident as an opportunity actually. And immediately Tulsi Bhai called a meeting of everybody and we decided let's go and meet the customers, understand their concern. And we promised to the customers that within 6 months of the time, we will reinstall all your turbines as it is actually. The vision of the company, the efforts, the teamwork worked like wonder for the company. Within 6 months, we erected new turbines, we commissioned everything. And a pleasant surprise, what we got from all the customers was another repeat order of 28 turbines, which was such a big order for the company in the year 1998. That gave us a real turning point to the company. And from there, like every year, we started doing 50 turbines, 100 turbines, 200 turbines. That changed the scale for the company.
We migrated, I would say, from Gujarat-based company to Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu, and then Pan-India company, and then global wind turbine company.
In one of the bankers meetings, Tulsi Bhai made a statement, then we will have some exports in US and we will exports in Europe and we will have larger presence in various countries of Suzlon. And one of the very senior banker told, there is a limit to seeing the dreams also. Come 2003, the first turbine got exported to US and that was the starting, and then company reached to 32 countries.
With its advanced manufacturing facilities and global presence, Suzlon today has more than 10,000 windmills across the globe. These windmills generate cleaner and greener energy, thus making the world a better place to live in.
In the last 20-year journey, by establishing 9,000 megawatt in India, we have provided 50 million populations access of the energy. I think that is the greatest satisfaction to me, and that is the great achievement of this Suzlon.
The Suzlon IPO was a much-talked IPO, and in fact, it was one of the most successful IPO of the times. The listing was fabulous. It was dear darling of the capital market.
The IPO gave Suzlon's ambitions a much-needed boost, and it went on an expansion spree with two great acquisitions.
Both the acquisitions were very, very strategic and well-timed, I would say. In 2006, Hinson was a great opportunity. It solved multiple issues for the company.
The Senvion acquisition in 2007 of 1.5 billion euros was a big, big leap by all the banks.
One important milestone that we achieved was achieving the super brand status for the brand quite early in life as we grew.
Suzlon, as an organization, believes in placing its people at the heart of everything they do. Not just the ones who work with them, but also the ones who work around them.
The basic objective of CSR at Suzlon incorporated enabling local communities to develop their potential, minimizing the impact on natural resources, and enabling the employees to become responsible civil society members.
Suzlon, being an Indian company, we wanted to create a headquarters which reflects our own values, because here the entire power has been on renewable basis. The water has been completely 100% harvesting. In fact, this project does not have any gutters and pipelines. So there is nothing that goes out of this campus. Therefore, it sustains. It has created its own ecosystem. Thus, we call this Earth within an Earth, and therefore it is known as Suzlon One Earth.
Suzlon is a mammoth force, lighting up lives of millions. However, during its extremely ambitious journey, it has had its share of darkness too.
The company started facing somewhat challenges from 2008-09 onwards. Post Lehman Brothers, the situation was that completely the market got vanished.
We were to make a choice between holding a strong asset or fixing our capital structure permanently. So we decided to fix our capital structure permanently. That very bold step taken by the company board of director has been immensely helpful in solving the liquidity issues and bringing back the company on a growth trajectory again.
People used to ask me, is it a sinking ship? And I used to say, well, it's a submarine. It's going for a deep dive and we'll come back, and we have come back now. So, but the amazing part is the entire thing in Suzlon is centering around the culture that Tulsi Bhai has created, and it's trickled down right from the top to the bottom, and that's one of the reasons that the passion is still continuing in this company.
Today, where we are, it is just because of one leader. He was so hardworking, so visionary, so motivator, and top of that, he's a very human being.
When the times are tough, one needs a leader who need not lead from the front, rather push people towards their goals.
Tulsi Bhai has been the most inspiring figure in the organization, always thinking something different.
Greatness is not in how you succeed, but in how you handle the failures and get over them. Such greatness comes only with belief, because it's only belief that empowers, surprises, and conquers. Belief is a promise to oneself to stand, come what may. And Suzlon is a story of belief.